Welcome everybody to my YouTube channel. This is Marky Park and today is Tuesday, May the 28th and it is 8:53 in the morning. I am currently at the Epcot parking lot and today I'm going into Epcot, but the goal is to go over to the Epcot resorts, which are Boardwalk Inn, the Yacht and Beach Club, and also the Walt Disney World Dolphin Resort. And the reason being is I'm continuing, this is part three of my adventure to find that Fix-It Felix Jr. arcade game. So I'm going to the three arcades over here at the Epcot area. And if I have time, I'll probably hop on the Skyliner and go over to the Caribbean Beach Resort because there's an arcade over there to check as well. So hopefully I can get four of those in today. So join me in part three as I go adventuring to find the Fix-It Felix Jr. arcade game. All right, so I'm walking through the parking lot right now. I recorded my car location in my Disney Experience app. I don't think I've ever parked over at Wally before, but that's where I'm at. Yeah, you can take a look here. Sign. Right there. Wally. So yeah, went off to the left here when I came into the parking area. So here is Spaceship Earth in the distance, and once I get inside I might get a jaw freeze and then head over to World Showcase. Probably on the way over we'll take a look at the new Communicore Hall and see if we can see anything new over there in the construction and anything else that's new. I think yesterday was the last day of the International Flower and Garden Festival, so I expect that all those food booths are probably closed today, but we'll find out when we get inside. So we just went through security here at Epcot and they still have scrims up for the International Flower and Garden Festival, so I don't know if it's still going maybe till the end of the week or if they just haven't taken down those scrims. But anyway, we're approaching the annual pass holder entrance over here and we'll be in just a minute. So yeah, I think the festival is officially over because we're at the entrance here where the Wish topiary was and this new flower is planted here. It's amazing how they update everything so quickly. Must have a massive team of landscapers that replace everything. Anyway, so that festival is over and there aren't any festivals going on at Epcot this summer. So the next festival will be the Food and Wine Festival, which begins, I believe, in August. So basically, pretty much the whole summer, there's no festivals here in Epcot. As I pass by the fountain here. So we're gonna go off to the right. And I did not even check on the Joffreys as I entered, so we got a group here. Looks like tour groups going through. So the park opened at 9 a.m. this morning, just a few minutes ago. 3 minutes ago, to be specific. There might have been early entry for guests at the resorts, I'm not sure. But there's definitely a pretty good, decent number of people here at Rope Drop. So yeah, right now I'm going to head over to World Showcase because we're going to go over to the resorts, which there's a walkway over by the Skyliner here at Epcot. That station right there, there's a walkway that will take you over to Boardwalk Inn, the Yacht Beach Club, and then I can walk over to the Dolphin as well. So in front of me here, we see the walls over here. This is a communicore hall, and we noticed, or I noticed, that there is a new sign up on here that wasn't here last time I made a video. It says Mickey and Friends here. And it does look like there's some construction workers over here. Looks like they're putting up some banners. Let's see if I can get it on film here. I'll have to zoom in a little bit probably. So yeah, it looks like there's some banners going up here. Different colored banners. Probably for that Encanto show that they announced will be over here at the Communicore Hall, and I believe that's opening next month here. So, probably just a few weeks away from this reopening. So right now I'm in World Celebration. This is the area that opened up earlier this year. And you've got a lot of nice little seating areas here. So when they do open this up, I'm sure there's some kind of restaurant. I think there might be a bar as well. So this will be a nice little seating area for that new hall that's going to open up here in about a month. So they haven't taken down all the topiaries yet, because they still have this one here with Mickey, Minnie, and Pluto, and Chippendale. Interesting. Yeah, so they just they took down some of the flowers and decorations, topiaries, but not all of them. The butterflies are still over here. But all the other plants that were here, you can see the spots on the ground. It was sponsored by Scentsy. Those are gone. So they're gradually taking stuff down. Also those portable stand-up trees that were in the middle here, in between these trees, are gone. They still have the floating flowers here on the water. So I would imagine they would keep these flowers here all season. But yeah, they've taken down some of the decorations and topiaries, but not all of them. The Encanto topiary is still up. See right here. And honestly, they haven't taken down any of the banners, because I just looked over here to my right. And this one is still here. So they still have some of the signage for the festival, but looks like all of those food booths are gone. And to be honest, we weren't overly impressed by the food that we tried. Usually we really look forward to coming out here and trying the festival food options and beverages, but this past one, that to us, at least to my wife and I, it was a little lackluster. But yeah, here's where the pineapple promenade was, and it's all closed up. I mean, they wouldn't open until like 11 anyway. But anyway, we're on our way over to World Showcase. You got some of the beehive boxes still up here. So So yeah, after Canada there is a jaw freeze, so that'll be probably my first stop. I'll get my jaw freeze fixed for the day. And maybe one of those chocolate croissants if they've got them. And then I'll take a stroll over to the Epcot area resorts. See if we can find that Fix-It Felix Jr. arcade. Alright, so I'm over at the UK Pavilion. I found a shady bench here across the way from the topiaries here. I got my strawberry dip mocha game changer. I asked specifically if they still had that. They still do serve that here, so just give you an idea. Right next to the Rose and Crown restaurant here, and then across the street you see Winnie the Pooh and Rabbit. You got Tigger, Piglet, and Eeyore. All those topiaries are still over here. So they've taken down some of the decorations, but not all of them yet. So over by the World Traveler, we're getting close to the exit over here at World Showcase in Epcot. And just notice that there must be a rental place for these scooters, because there's a whole line of them right here. I don't think I've ever noticed that before. But yeah, there's a whole bunch of them out here. So if you don't already own a scooter and you need one to ride around in the park, because this is a fairly large park, you come over here, it looks like, to the World Traveler and rent one of those scooters. Alright, we're approaching the exit here. Alright. You see the Disney Skyliner is right over here, right outside the exit here. Well, we're gonna walk past this. We'll probably come back to the Skyliner later, because I think I'm gonna stop over at Caribbean Beach Resort, see if we can take a look at that arcade over there. So on my list I have on my phone, there's a total of, it looks like, 20 Walt Disney World resorts that have arcades, video arcades. We've been to 9 of them so far, so we got 11 left. See if I can knock out at least 4 of those today. So doing some security guard training over here, which is pretty cool. Here's the entry to the Disney Skyliner. And we're gonna keep walking straight over to the Boardwalk Inn, which I believe is the first resort that we'll come up across here when we go over this walking path here. Now they do have what they call the friendship boats, which I've taken before over here at Epcot. Those boats will actually take you to all the Epcot area resorts and will also take you to Hollywood Studios, which is nice. So that's about a little bit under half an hour total trip time, I believe. Maybe about 20-25 minutes on that boat to get from here to Hollywood Studios. But here you see there's a sign over here. There's actually a map too. Oh, this is a map for smoking locations. I've never seen that before. So there's 2, it looks like. There's one over here at the gateway, and there's one outside, it looks like, the park entrance. Here we go, we got a sign that says we got the walkway to Disney's boardwalk, the Yacht and Beach Resort, and the Disney World Swan and Dolphin. So according to the Walt Disney World website, the Dolphin also has an arcade. Technically those aren't Walt Disney World resorts, those I believe are owned by Hilton, but they have been here way longer than any of these other resorts here, the Swan and Dolphin. They were here in 1986 when we first visited, when my family first came to Walt Disney World. So yeah, we're just gonna go across here and we'll be at the Boardwalk Inn here in just a couple minutes. Okay, I was mistaken. I thought that the Boardwalk Inn was the first resort, but I believe it's the Yacht and Beach Club. Let's take a look at this real quick. So the convention center here. Beach Club Villas. I'm taking a look here to see. This is where the arcade is. Lafferty Arcade, it says, is F. Let's find F. Okay, it's up here. And we are down here. So we gotta go in the main entrance here, and we're gonna go down this hall to the left. Okay. So, we've never stayed at these resorts, but we've definitely been inside before. And I definitely see the main attraction to staying here is you're literally right next to Epcot. So you just walk across that little bridge I was just on, and here you are. You're over in the park. So I would say at least half of the people that visit Walt Disney World are foreigners, which I have no problem with, but you can definitely tell that they're not American because they do silly things like stand right in the middle of the walking paths or doorways. So right here is the, now I don't know if, I think this is the yacht club. Let's see if we can see a welcome mat here. Oh! I was wrong, it's Disney's Beach Club Resort. So we're gonna head over this way. There's the guest check-in over here. Looks like they have a restaurant serving breakfast right now called Cape May. So last night when I was considering coming over here this morning, I did actually look at breakfast options. Yeah, they have a breakfast buffet. This is one of the places I actually looked at, but the only reservation they had was like at 7:15 in the morning, which, because I'm not staying here, would not be possible unless I drove my car over here and parked actually at the resort. I just didn't feel like, plus at 7:15 in the morning, it was a little early. My alarm went off at 7, so anyway, I am considering maybe getting something to eat. If I go over to the Skyliner, I could always take that over to Hollywood Studios. So, it's been a while since I've been to the Sci-Fi. Just saying. Okay, so we got Martha's Vineyard Lounge here. This is probably open in the evenings. Looks very nice. It looks like another restaurant here, maybe. It says Ariel's. So you gotta walk outside to go inside, I guess. In the pool area here. See the lifeguards gathering there. Fairly decent sized pool. I like the windmill. Nice. A waterfall over there. Oh, Beaches and Cream. Look at that. A little ice cream shop here. Nice. So yeah, it says Beaches and Cream Soda Shop. And they open at 11 o'clock. Oh, they do have a lunch menu here. Some burgers, a Reuben sandwich, cheddar bacon ranch chicken sandwich. That sounds pretty good. That's a little pricey. A little bit. I would say oh, guess what I just found when I looked over to my left. I see some arcade games. But the average price we usually pay for a quick serve meal is probably between $12 and $14. Sometimes, if we're lucky, we find it cheaper. But yeah, here's a sign here for Lafferty Place Arcade. says it opens at 8, so it should be open. Let's take a look. Right away, you see the Marvel Venture Labs, which you might have seen in my previous videos. Step Maniacs. That looks like something I haven't seen at the other arcades. Oh, we got some Poison playing in the background. Yeah. Guitar Hero. Who's that? Got that air hockey we saw the other day. Some more Pac-Man Baller, and of course Pac-Man's Pixel Bash. Every single arcade we've been to has had this one, and probably all of them have had Wicked Tuna. It's not the largest arcade I've been to at the parks. We got some more racers over here. A photo booth. Bigfoot Crush, oh that sounds fun. Galaga Assault, I don't think I remember seeing that one either. Pac-Man Chomp Mania. So there are a few different arcades that we haven't seen before, but fortunately no Fix-It Felix Jr. So guess we're off to the Boardwalk Inn next. Got cut off there, I don't know what happened to the video. So we're just walking by the last building here at Disney's Yacht Club. And again, you see the wooden planks here telling us we're headed over to the Boardwalk Inn. These nice little white benches here. It's a nice morning, nice breeze. It was in the high 90s, I think around 96 or so yesterday. Here's a sign telling us we are headed over to Disney's Boardwalk. And the Swan and Dolphin are actually right here too. I actually thought we would get to the Boardwalk first, so actually let's go ahead and take a trip over to the Walt Disney World Dolphin Resort. A dark wooded path over here. I'm not sure that takes you to the resort. I'm just going to take this path here. Is the friendship boat trolls by here on its way to, looks like, pick up passengers here at the Swan and Dolphin Resorts. This is an older resort. The Swan and Dolphins are definitely from the 80s. Another sign for Boardwalk. I'm just gonna follow this gentleman here with his backpack. He's probably headed to the entrance, I'm assuming. So across the way is the Swan Resort. Some Florida wildlife, but yeah, I think the entrance to the Dolphin Resort is going to be around the corner here, and if we're lucky we'll see a map like we did for, like I saw, found at the Beach Club Resort, that shows where that arcade is. But if not, we'll just do some exploring. So that's what I'll this is basically what this is about today, is exploring and going to some places, honestly, that I haven't never been to before. We've been to these resorts, we just haven't really explored them. And I'm sure I've been to the Swan and Dolphin, I just don't really have any distinct memories of what's inside. So you definitely get your steps in here. You got this fairly long and winding path. There's this little channel right here that leads to nowhere. Not exactly sure why in the construction that was necessary. Anyway, A lot of palm trees here. Looks like maybe these are recently planted, maybe in the last few years, because they've got some support still. So I do see a sign, or the sign actually, that does say Disney Water Taxi, but also it looks like there's an entry to the resort here. Let's see if we can, looks like it's just a handicap accessible, so I don't think it's going to be locked. Let's try to get in. There you go. You can see the carpet there. There's a restaurant there. Todd English's Blue Zoo. Oh, here we go. Your destination, resort lobby, convention space, Disney transportation. Lobby, level one. Or level L. Let's see. There we go. Level L. I've never been in these before. Chill frozen drinks. I like the scrims on there. It's pretty cool. So, just kind of explore a little bit while we're here. We got a spa, Andara spa. It looks very common. I like the theming here. It looks kind of like underwater vegetation. I see a sign for Shula's Steakhouse. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Oh, we gotta take a selfie with this guy, right? Two. Let's see. Let me get you in there. That'll make a nice thumbnail. Very nice. So, it looks like here's the main lobby. Looks like the bar area here. Wow, this is massive. Look at this. Yeah, old tiles here on the ground. This definitely has the 80s feel, but also feels. I'm getting a definitely Hilton. You can see some hints of like the Hilton, especially like the one in Anaheim. I like these here. Looks like a Q-Bert board here on the floor. This is over by the bar. So I'm looking to see if we can find a map. Looks like there's a restaurant or Starbucks or something over here. It says Disney Gift Sundries. We got some bus transportation up ahead. This place is called Fuel. This is a really interesting resort here. It says Resort Essentials. This go outside to the bus transportation maybe. Maybe. What we got up on the sign up here? Oh, it's another sign for the shop. Where? I was kind of trying to find this place without asking for help, but I don't have to. I really just need to find a map. Let's walk over here, shall we? As we pass by the fuel, we've got coffee, sandwiches, salads, frozen yogurt, juices and drinks, sweets and candy. I see Froyo. Guys, looks like a pretty cool place. So I do see a cast, or I keep saying cast member, but there's somebody here at the desk will ask about the arcade. Good morning.
Hello, how are you?
Maybe you can help me. I'm trying to find the video arcade.
Oh yeah, so you're going to follow this walkway. You see that second palm tree?
Uh-huh.
You're going to take the west elevators down to the first floor.
Okay.
Once you get off the elevator, make a right. You're going to see Peekaboo, keep going straight, and then you'll see it right before the laundry room.
Okay.
Alrighty.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
So yeah, she says it's on level one. That's where we were before. So take the elevators and head down to the arcade. So we're down on level one here at Walt Disney World Dolphin Resort. And there's a sign right here. It says Camp Dolphin Game Room. Looks like there's another restaurant here. Like Caribbean theme. There's a sign actually in the restaurant that says game room. Let's take a look. That's a really cool theme. Yeah, there's a sign right here that says game room. Can we access it from here? Oh yeah, here we go. Okay. Well, Pac-Man basket, that's different than the other ones, huh? Deal or no deal? I haven't seen any of these arcades anywhere else. There's a really large skee ball machine. They have a Sonic air hockey. Very cool. Keymaster, Lily Crash, ha ha ha, funny. Oh, look at this, that's right. Come with me if you want to live. So you got a Terminator arcade here. What is this? Look at this guy. Winner takes all these prizes in here. Oh yeah, back in the day, going to the mall, you find one of those machines here that had all these little clamshell toys. You even got some claw machines here. A machine you can pick out tickets, that's interesting, yeah. Wow. Never seen anything like that. Duck catcher. I think I heard Mickey. Space Invaders. Spin and Win. Dizzy Chicken. Another Nerf arcade. Of course, you've got to have the Marvel Adventure Lab. In every single arcade in Walt Disney World. Hey, a Jurassic Park? That's different. Definitely haven't seen this one. Yeah. Flappy tickets. And a Batman game. I haven't seen that anywhere. So some unique arcade games here. It's not a very large one, but it's got a lot of cool games. But unfortunately, no Wreck-It Ralph, no Fix-It Felix Jr. games. So the next stop's gonna be Boardwalk, and then maybe we'll head over to Caribbean Beach Resort. For some reason, I'm having some technical issues here with the camera. I just recorded some video here that never recorded, I guess. But yeah, we're leaving the Swan and Dolphin Resort here, going across this bridge. There's a pontoon boat going across here. This is the boardwalk over here. And we were just at this one over here, which is the Dolphin Resort. Yeah, I don't know what's going on with the camera, but anyway, what I was saying before was that the arcade over there definitely had some machines that we haven't seen at any of the other arcades here in Walt Disney World. They had those claw machines. They had a claw machine that looked like you could pick tickets out, like rolls of tickets for prizes. And I don't know where you would turn those in at the resort, but they're very unique. Alright, so right here's a big sign here that says Disney's Boardwalk. And we're gonna walk right under these arches here. See if we can find that arcade. Is this an actual road? The van just drove through here. Yeah. Okay. But we've been here before as well. We haven't stayed at the boardwalk, but we were here during a downpour one night. And we actually hid underneath the awning of this Dueling Pianos right here. This is probably something that's probably only open at night, for dinner probably. Yeah, we hid right underneath here. Yeah, hours of operation at 7 to 1:45 a.m. Oh, wow. So all the talk online is about the corn dog station over here at Boardwalk opening. They're doing a lot of refurbishment, it looks like, here. Yeah, I think that I see the other side here where that corn dog kiosk is. I'm honestly not sure where to find that arcade. Just keep my eyes peeled here. When I was at the Dolphin, I had to actually ask an employee because it's such a massive place. And I didn't see any maps. That's what I was looking for. I was just trying to see if I could find a map that would tell us where that arcade would be. And I couldn't find a map for the hotel. So I'm not too proud to ask somebody for help. And they did. They helped me. Looks like a gift shop here. Character Carnival. Says general store. See the boardwalk here. Some benches here to hang out at. There's a sign up here, but I don't know if it's an actual. Let's see what it says. I think it says resort activities. So pool activities, movie under the stars, so on and so forth. This might lead to the main building here, let's see. This says Promenade, Fine Art Gallery here. pretty neato. I do see some signage here. Let's see. Oh. Okay, this is what we're looking for. Perfect. So the pool is next door here, but at the bottom it says Sideshow Arcade. So I can see in the window here is the fitness center. Got a nice breeze, and look at what we just found. We found the arcade. Let's go inside. All right, this is it here. Fruit Ninja. Oh, this is Pac-Man's arcade party. Like Galaga's on there right now. Oh, right here we got Galaga Galaxian, Galaga 88, Xevious, the Dragon Spirit. Some of these I can't read. Rally X, Rolling Thunder, Mappy, Dig Dug on there. One of the all-time favorite arcade games. That's the break. Clown game here, Daytona. Nitro Trucks. Oh, Nitro Police here. Another Wicked Tuna arcade. Amazing Angels. There's an arcade collection here. But we got the Defender games here. And again, we got another Pac-Man's Pixel Bash. It's not a very large arcade. But yeah, unfortunately, no Fix-It Felix Jr. So it means we're done here at the Epcot Resort. So next stop would be head back over to Epcot, get on that Skyliner, and head over to the Caribbean Beach Resort. And that would be number 4 for today. And there you go. As we're walking around the rest of the boardwalk here, you see there's a station here to rent the Surrey bikes, which we saw over at Saratoga Springs on Saturday. Those look like a lot of fun. And we've heard a lot about the Flying Fish. There's some people say this is the best restaurant on Walt Disney World property. Haven't tried it yet, but judging by the name of the restaurant, it's probably a seafood restaurant, which I would thoroughly enjoy. There's a bar right next door here, and here we go. So it's the Blue Ribbon Corn Dogs. I believe this is also over in Anaheim, so everybody online is anxiously waiting the opening of this here. I don't know if they've announced an official opening date yet. You've got looks like an Italian restaurant here. So I've done a lot in an hour. Right now it's 10:14 in the morning. And I visited three resort arcades already today. You've got Boardwalk Joe's Margaritas here. And then the deli. Boardwalk Deli. And there's an ice cream shop over here, right next door. I think we've been to the ice cream shop. Looks like they're building a new shop here. It says the Cake Bake Shop coming soon. See some pictures of what they're gonna have here. That tart looks pretty good. Some little rose frosting roses there. Got some waffles, a strawberry shortcake. Okay, assortment of cake bites there. It's probably the owner here. delicious looking chocolate cake, birthday cake. It's like a raspberry cake. And not sure what that is. It's a salad and something that looks like has hollandaise on it. It's like lemon bars. And that looks too sweet for me. So yeah, probably somewhere I shouldn't be eating at. So we've almost made our way all the way around boardwalk in this lagoon here, where I see a friendship boat in the distance. That means we're coming back around to Epcot and the World Gateway there. And then I think I'm gonna hop on that Skyliner. We'll go over to Caribbean Beach Resort, which is might be the biggest or the most expansive of the resorts down here in Walt Disney World. So definitely gonna need a map to find where that arcade's at. So I'm on my way back over to Epcot. We're approaching the Disney Skyliner over here at Epcot, and just thought maybe we'd do something a little bit different here, change it up. So we're gonna play a round of the Skyliner roulette and see if we get a character scrim. Here the gondola's coming in. There's the entry over here. This is the Disney Skyliner. So basically I'm gonna hop on one of these here. And then if it does have a character scrim on it, before I leave today, I'll have to find the ride or attraction, meet and greet, something that has to do with that character scrim on the gondola. But first stop is going to be the Caribbean Beach Resort. We're going to get off there and we're going to take a look and see if we can find the arcade over at that resort, and keep our fingers crossed that maybe we'll find Fix-It Felix Jr. So right now it's 10:21 in the morning. Caribbean Beach Resort's pretty close by, so it shouldn't take us very long to get there. I see coming around the corner, there's some of the gondolas here. We got Winnie the Pooh, Tigger. Good morning. Thank you. So we did not get a Skyliner that had a character on it. So it means we don't have to do that challenge today. We'll do it again some other day. Today's a short day. I gotta be at work at 3 o'clock. Still got more than 4 hours before I have to be at work, so not a problem. So this is the end, or the north end of this Disney Skyliner, is over here at Epcot as we go over the river here. And there's France.
Welcome aboard the Disney Skyliner at Epcot International Gateway. We're flying to Disney's Riviera Resort with a final stop at Disney's Caribbean Beach Resort.
Oh, it's going to Riviera first. Oh, I better check and see if there's an arcade there, to be honest. It's the newest resort, I think, in the parks, but I'll go double check and make sure there isn't one over at Riviera.
We hope you are enjoying your journey on the most magical flight on Earth. We are now traveling along Buena Vista Drive.
That's over here on my right. So I was incorrect earlier. I said Caribbean Beach is just right around the corner. From Epcot, you have to stop at the Riviera Resort first. If you're coming from Hollywood Studios, Caribbean Beach Resort would be the first stop. So it's probably about between 10 to 15 minute total ride time to get over to the Caribbean Beach Resort. Kind of see all the other gondolas going by here. When these things are moving, you get a nice breeze, but man, when it stops, it can be a little uncomfortable inside these. Especially now, it's starting to heat up.
In just a few moments, we will be arriving at Disney's Riviera Resort, a Disney vacation club. As one of the most picturesque vacation destinations in the world, the European Riviera has fascinated and inspired many great artists over the centuries, including Walt Disney himself.
Right below us here is the Walt Disney World Fire Station. You can get a good view here. Going across Buena Vista Drive here. Up ahead is the Riviera Resort.
Welcome to Disney's Riviera Resort. If you are traveling to Disney's Caribbean Beach Resort, Disney's Hollywood Studios, Disney's Pop Century Resort, or Disney's Art of Animation Resort, please remain on board.
So we are going to remain on board because we're going to continue on to the Caribbean Beach Resort. There's actually some buildings here for Caribbean Beach Resort right next to us here. That's how massive this Caribbean Beach Resort is. It's literally next to this one here.
Thank you for flying with us. Riviera Resort, a Disney vacation club. If you are just joining us, we are on our way to Disney's Caribbean Beach Resort with connecting flights to Disney's Hollywood Studios, Disney's Pop Century Resort, and Disney's Art of Animation Resort. Say bon voyage to the Mediterranean. We are about to go island hopping at Disney's Caribbean Beach Resort.
All these buildings here belong to the Caribbean Beach Resort, and each section of the resort is dedicated to a different island. So I think Jamaica is the most central, I think, of all the sections of the resort. I think we'll head towards that one.
We are now sailing over Disney's Caribbean Beach Resort, where every day feels like a junk-a-new celebration.
Hopefully we'll be able to find a map. I think there's one near the Skyliner station, and that might give us a clue to where the arcade's at.
In just a few moments, we will be landing at Disney's Caribbean Beach Resort.
I do notice there is a pond. It looks like a pontoon boat over here on the water. Because this resort is so massive, I wouldn't be surprised if they have ferry boats that take you from one side to another.
Welcome to the islands of Disney's Caribbean Beach Resort. All passengers must disembark or transfer at this station. Thank you. We hope you enjoyed the most magical flight on Earth.
Right, we are at the Caribbean Beach Resort. It's 10:35 in the morning. It seems like I've accomplished quite a bit in a short amount of time. Here's what we're looking at here, the Caribbean Beach Resort. There is a map over here next to the Skyliner station, so let's take a peek at it real quick. It's not very detailed, I don't think. It just shows you kind of the different sections. So you've got Trinidad, Barbados, Old Port Royal, Martinique. It shows the Riviera on here as well. Aruba, Jamaica. Ooh, I want to take you. To Bermuda, I don't see that on here, or Bahama. But yeah, it does show you a little bit here. Pool bar, dining. I don't see anything here. We're gonna go to the Royale, I think. So it looks like we gotta go across the bridge here. And then go to the left, it looks like, to Old Port Royale. So according to the signage here, we're approaching Martinique and Port Royale, which is the main building here at Caribbean Beach Resort. I like that they put these little maps all along the way here on the walking path to kind of see where we're at. It says, you are here. Yeah, so we're just right around the corner from Old Port Royale. I see that it looks like the main check-in over here to my right. This building over here. Now we have stayed at this resort. I distinctly remember it was in 2016 because we were in the food court, and while we were having dinner, I was watching the Cubs and Dodgers play each other in the playoffs. So that would have been October of 2016. And we got this really cool pool area here with an old, like, Spanish fort. And this path goes into the parking lot, which is a little odd. But the pool area is blocked off to guests, so there's no way for me to go that way. It's a little odd, but yeah, you got all the Disney vehicles parked over here. So yeah, this is gonna take us through this little parking lot over to the main lobby, it looks like. It's still a little early for lunch, so I don't think I'm gonna stop here to eat. But I am considering going over to Hollywood Studios. Maybe we'll try something over there. There we go. So yeah, you got some valet cars coming up here.
Good morning.
Good morning. I'm longing for some air conditioning here.
Okay.
Nice and cool inside. Welcome to the Caribbean Beach Resort. So, you've got the shop over here, the Calypso Trading Post. You've got one of the quick service restaurants here. This is probably where we ate when we stayed here. It's the Centertown Market. Looks like the main lobby check-in is over here. Kind of hoping there'd be a map. There's a map out here. Cool area. Let's see. So these are the activities here. Nothing there that says anything about the arcade. I can't really say here. Might have to do a little Google search here and see where that arcade is. Okay, so I just spoke to a cast member over here at the Caribbean Beach Resort, and apparently they need to update the Disney website because they do not have an arcade here anymore, according to the cast member. It used to be over here at the check-in area, but when they remodeled, I guess recently, they took that out. So yeah, unfortunately no arcade here, so I'll have to take that off the list I created. So I guess right now the plan is to head back over to the Skyliner and I think maybe we'll head over to Hollywood Studios. It's almost 11 o'clock, 10:52. And let me see if we can get a bite to eat over at Hollywood Studios. Maybe catch a ride before I head home. I didn't film any of this before when I came over to the Caribbean Beach Resort, but there's several white sandy beaches here. This one's actually got a hammock. But you're just on a white sandy beach facing a swampy Florida lagoon here. So only at Disney would they create a Caribbean beach with lily pads. I guess they do the best they can to make it feel like you're in on a Caribbean island, but I mean, yeah, this is about as good as you can get, making it look like you're on a island beach, I guess. But yeah, you can see across the way here, across this little lagoon, there's another beach, a much larger one. I think we're gonna pass by another one here in a little bit, but. So yeah, we're gonna head over here to this bridge in the distance, go across and then get back on the Skyliner station, which is behind this building right here. And then probably head over to Hollywood Studios for a quick visit. Just got on the Skyliner over here at Caribbean Beach Resort on the Hollywood Studios road. So gonna stop over at Hollywood Studios. Can we take a look and see if there's anything interesting on the menus over there?
Ladies, maybe get something for lunch. And islanders of all ages, welcome to Disney Skyliner at Disney's Caribbean Beach Resort. We're flying to Disney's Hollywood Studios.
So you can see over here in the distance. It's kind of hard through this screen.
Throughout his life and career,
that's the Hollywood
Walt
Tower
Disney
of Terror.
Had a passion for animals and the natural world. Today, we are traveling through one of the many protected wetlands here at Walt Disney World Resort. If you're lucky, you might spot some of the happiest wildlife on Earth.
So yeah, a lot of this natural wildlife is still untouched. This native flora here to Florida. Florida flora. Actually, over here in the distance, I don't know if I can get it on the camera at this angle here, is the swan and dolphin. Maybe we get a little bit closer. Get past these trees here. Nice breeze coming in here. There you go. Over in the distance there, that's the Swan Resort. On the other side would be Dolphin, which we were at earlier today.
In just a few minutes, we will be arriving at Disney's Hollywood Studios. Whether you plan to visit a galactic outpost or play with all of Andy's toys, at Disney's Hollywood Studios, everyone can become the stars of their favorite cinematic stories.
There are quite a few dining options here at Hollywood Studios, including over in Galaxy's Edge. I could get a Ronto Roaster.
Before you walk the red carpet, remember to double-check your star-studded itinerary using your My Disney Experience mobile app.
I looked on the app earlier for reservations, hoping that maybe something for the sci-fi dining theater might show up. But yeah, I didn't see anything. Funny enough, Oga's Cantina had reservations, which I think is hilarious since it's a bar and they don't actually have meals.
Station.
looks like there's a steady stream of people going into the park here.
And watch your steps. Thank you for flying with us.
Here we go.
Hi there, how are you?
Good. Thanks. A little bit of a wait there, but we're in. See Mickey on top of the world. So I've been thinking about it. I think maybe I will head back to Galaxy's Edge. And if I don't get a Ronto Roaster, maybe check out what's over at Docking Bay 7. Those are the two main eateries back there. Choose to walk in the shade here. So right now it's 11:14 in the morning, so I've been out for a little bit over 2 hours now. So my search for Fix-It Felix Jr. arcade unfortunately has not come to fruition yet. I visited three of the arcades today, thought I was gonna hit up a fourth one over at Caribbean Beach Resort, and then found out that they actually don't have one anymore. They did some construction in the last few years, and recently. And it sounds like they remodeled that area where the arcade was, which used to be over in the lobby there at the Port Royal building. So yeah, a little bit of a bummer. But I'm gonna take the long way around here. This path doesn't look like it gets walked very often here, as we see the fountain and the dockside diner there. I think this is Gertie up here, the dinosaur. I don't think I've ever ordered anything from the dinosaur, which I think is a ice cream or soda shop. Passing by the 50s Primetime Cafe here. Another view of Gertie. It's lunchtime for Gertie. It looks like she's eating. Yeah, I think this is the ice cream shop here. Ice cream of extinction. We got waffle cones. It looks like they just opened. Looks like maybe the Indiana Jones Epic Stunt Spectacular just ended, because there's a lot of folks over here by the entrance. Honestly, might hop on Star Tours here too. We're gonna pass by one of the quick serve restaurants over here. I stepped in something sticky. My shoe is sticking to the ground. But yeah, the Backlot Express restaurant is right in front of us here. This is where they used to have the Honey, I Shrunk the Kids playground, I believe. Yeah, we're coming up. There's the restaurant right here. Star Tours in front of us with the walker aiming its guns on these crowds of innocent civilians. Actually, it says the standby line is 40 minutes, so that tells me that this park is pretty busy right now, because usually that's about a 10-minute wait. So yeah, I see people in the outdoor queue here. It's quite busy. And keep in mind, this is a Tuesday, but it is the unofficial beginning of summer. Yesterday was Memorial Day, so probably a lot of families coming after school ended. Most kids are probably out of school for the summer. I could go over to the Sci-Fi Dine-In and try to do walk-up, but I don't know. And maybe it's not really worth it. I think I'm going to go over to Galaxy's Edge instead. So that's going to be in that tunnel right there. Judging by the video here, the A-Wing, now officially in Galaxy's Edge here. I keep tripping myself on the ground here. I don't know what the deal is. Is it exhaustion or what? But we're gonna head over this way to the marketplace. It does seem super crowded right now. It was crowded getting in here, and the tunnel was packed. So it definitely feels like summer in the parks here. Look at the Black Spire Outpost here. I don't know if I never noticed that there's an obelisk here by the restrooms. Wow, look at these little statue carvings over here. I never noticed those before. So you got a Chewbacca maybe down there at the bottom. Some Porgs. That might be Doc Ondar right there. Got a Loaf Cat. Maybe a R2 unit. All these weapons over here on the wall. I like these Star Wars tikis. Really cool. Okay. The marketplace isn't overly busy. I think the popcorn shop is gotta be busy. Yeah, because of the popcorn buckets. I've already seen a couple of them. You got the Stormtrooper helmet popcorn buckets. Had that really good coffee drink over here too. I think we're gonna walk around the corner to the docking bay. It's definitely quite busy over here and loud. Very busy over here. I believe you can mobile order at this restaurant. Take a look and see how busy it is. I might find a shady spot and try to do a mobile order. Take a look at the menu. It says it's open. Take a look at the menu. Stir fry. Pork ribs. Andorian fried chicken. Yep, chicken. Chicken salad. That beef stir fry actually looks pretty good. We got some of the adult beverages down here below. I'll take a look at the menu online, see what it looks like. Literally just placed my order probably about a minute ago over here at the Ronto Roasters. And it already says it's ready. Mobile order pickup one. very fast. Considering how busy it is in the park, I'm amazed that the order went through that quickly. Yeah, I'll go over here to number one and pick up my order. All right, so I was over at Ronto Roasters and I got a Ronto wrap. See, I've got the pork sausage sticking out the end there. It's got that slaw. It's also got the shaved pork. I also got my trusty zero sugar Minute Maid lemonade. And they did have a large cup available over there. So I'm actually over in the outside dining area of the Docking Bay 7, which I had breakfast here not too long ago. So this is a nice shady spot. It's got some, I can show you. It's got some like little stools here. So try the Ronto Roaster. I haven't had one of these in a while, but it's one of my favorite entree items here at the park. That pork sausage is crispy on the outside. On a large piece of pita bread. I haven't got much of the sliced pork yet. Although this is a little messy to eat, it just comes in this paper wrap. So if you're thinking about ordering this, just keep that in mind. Either the sauce or the slaw that's on here has a little bit of spice. I did have a breakfast wrap a few weeks ago here. Although it tastes all right, I think this is the regular Ronto wrap is a much better value. And I can put that receipt over here. It was I think $13.29 or $13.49. It's a little bit spicy. I did look at the menu for the Docking Bay 7. There's some interesting menu options. But the wrap actually sounded better to me. I feel that air conditioning. Another reason why I parked my keister over here is you can see the door opening behind me. Just a quick tip if you come over to the Docking Bay 7. And you want to sit down to eat, and you don't want to sit inside, or there's no seating inside. Sit right by the door here, because when it opens up, like it does right there, get a nice blast of cold air. I am in a shady spot here under this tree too. Got some nice ambiance. I got my first real bite of that shaved pork. Let's see if I can show you the cross section there. The shaved pork is down at the bottom. So, I don't think I've ever done a review on my channel for the Ronto wrap. This is probably the first time I've eaten it since I unofficially started the channel back in October. I haven't been to all the spots yet at Hollywood Studios as far as dining goes, but as quick serve goes, the Ronto wrap is probably the best of those quick serve items that I've had in the park, I would definitely give the Bronto wrap a thumbs up 5 out of 5. Because one, it's hearty. You've got a lot of food here, so it's a good value, I think. And it's a nice blend of hot and cold. So you've got the cold slaw on top of the pork sausage and that shaved pork on the bottom. And there is another sauce on here down in the bottom. That might be where the spice is coming from. I'm not really sure. But yeah, my nose is starting to run a little bit. But yeah, this is a good lunch meal here at Galaxy's Edge. So, just got done eating lunch over at Monto Roasters. And we're over by the garage here. We got some droids working on some speeders. There is a walkway here where some of the characters come out occasionally, but there's nobody out here now. It's 11:49 in the morning. Right next to this garage is the Bounty Hunter station. You see there's some people lined up over here. There's some background noise here. Sure what that sound's coming from. Sounds like pod racer announcers or something. But yeah, I'm just gonna walk our way back out to out of the park to the Disney Skyliner. I had to head back over to Epcot. I thought maybe I'd stop at Star Tours and hop on there. But it was a 40-minute wait, it said on the sign, which is rather lengthy wait time for that ride. Basically, if it's 30 minutes or more of a wait time in for Star Tours, that tells you how busy the park is. Because in most days, that Star Tours ride is about 10-minute wait. 15 max. But yeah, pretty busy, as you can see here, the crowds in front of me. We're actually going to walk by the entrance to Rise of the Resistance, so we'll see what, get an idea how busy it is by the wait time for this ride as well. If it's like 2 hours, that gives you an idea here. Let's see. Okay, there's not quite a 2 hour wait. It says 70 minutes, so a little bit over an hour. So, a bit busy. Yep, so we're just gonna work our way back out of Galaxy's Edge here, head towards the exit to the park. Alright, so it is officially 12 o'clock noon, as it says here on my watch. And we just exited Disney's Hollywood Studios. So, in all, it's been a total of 3 hours today over here at the Walt Disney World Resorts and the two parks, Epcot and Hollywood Studios. So, I didn't ride on any rides. That wasn't the goal today. I went to a total of 4 Walt Disney World Resorts. I count the Yacht and Beach Club as one. So I was at Yacht and Beach Club, Boardwalk, the Dolphin Resort, and then finally over to Caribbean Beach Resort. And unfortunately, all 4 of those resorts' arcades did not have a Fix-It Felix Jr. So I think before I make my next trip out to the resorts, we'll do some more research online and see if those arcades actually still exist. Well, at least exist here in Walt Disney World. So, yeah, we're going to get back on Skyliner. We're going to head back over to Epcot here. Yep. Well. So, like I said earlier in the video, I believe yesterday was the last day of Epcot's International Flower and Garden Festival. There are still some topiaries on display at the park. They did take down the main entrance display, which was from Disney's Wish movie. But it looked like most of the other topiaries are still on display. They even still have the signs up. So, it's been a 3-hour day. Like I said, I feel like I did a lot in 3 hours. Lunch was good. That Ronto Roaster is always a good choice, I think, over at Hollywood Studios. And so yeah, it was a good day. We're gonna hop on one of these gondolas here and head over towards the Caribbean Beach station and get off there and get on the Epcot, monorail. Skyliner over at Caribbean Beach, to head over to Epcot. Sorry if I forgot to mention what I was wearing today. I've got my Epcot hat on since we went over to Epcot today, or the Epcot Resorts. And I wore my classic Disney shirt here. It's actually double-sided, so on the back it actually shows the backside of those characters. So while I'm in the Skyliner here, I think since we're headed over to Epcot, it is 12:07 right now. We'll probably be over there around 12:15.
We will be arriving at Disney's Caribbean Beach Resort shortly.
We're going to Caribbean Beach first.
All passengers must disembark and transfer at this station. Thank you, and we hope you enjoy the most magical flight on Earth.
So I think a few weeks ago I was over at World Showcase. I was over at China and the Japan pavilions looking for wind chimes. And I returned to go purchase one of those wind chimes over in the Japan pavilion, and they were completely out of the goldfish.
Please
chime.
Remain seated.
So I think since I'm headed that way anyway, I'm going to be in the World Showcase when I get off the Skyliner. I think I'm going to hop over to Japan real quick, see if I can find that wind chime. Because I know my wife really liked that goldfish, and it was gone when I went back a couple weeks later. So since I'm headed that way, let's go take a look and see if I can find that goldfish wind chime over at the Japan Pavilion. Alright, we are back in Epcot. And look who's here. Getting pictures with folks. M-I-C-K-E-Y M-O-U-S-E Mickey Mouse. Look at that. Okay, so before we head out of the park, we are in the World Showcase. To my right here, there is a bridge that goes over to France. And after France is Morocco. And after Morocco is Japan. So we're gonna walk over to the Japan Pavilion and go into the shop over in Japan. And fingers crossed, maybe we'll find that goldfish wind chime over here. We're at the Japan Pavilion. We're at Mitsukoshi. We're getting into some air conditioning here. It's quite busy here. So I've been in this shop a few times and on my channel, and I know exactly where I'm headed here for the wind chimes. So I am running short on time. It's exactly 12:30 right now. I have to be at work at 3. Time is limited here. I'm playing some drums here behind me. I smell the incense. Mm-hmm. Hello. Here's the wind chimes here. Don't think they have the goldfish. They have the dolphin. No goldfish. I guess the wind chimes are really popular right now. I'll just have to come back again another time. I like the frog though up there. No goldfish. Alright, I'm over at the Morocco Pavilion here at the World Showcase in Epcot. Just heard a rumble of thunder here. And here pretty soon. Look at the skies here above me. Kind of surrounded by clouds right now. So, yep. I think we're going to see a shower here in just a few short moments. But I am now on my way out of the park. I did actually park at Epcot parking lot. So I need to make my way all the way back to the front. So I'm at the back of the park. And the wind is starting to pick up. That's a good sign that we're probably going to see some showers here any moment. Let's see if I can catch the beginning of that storm. Oh, look at all the flowers blowing off the trees. I actually grabbed my hat. I felt a gust of wind. I thought my hat was going to blow away. Yeah, these folks in front of me with some hats as well. I actually thought about taking one of the ferry boats across to a World Celebration across the lagoon here, but it left just a couple minutes ago. Yeah, all signs point to a storm here pretty soon. At least some showers. It cooled down significantly in the last couple minutes. It was about 90 degrees outside, probably dropped a couple of degrees. Yeah, look at the clouds over here in front of me. Those probably aren't rain clouds, but definitely above us here. Looking like rain. There goes the ferry boat. So it's 12:39 right now. So I've been here for over 3.5 hours, and checked off a few of those Walt Disney World resorts with the video arcades, looking for a Fix-It Felix Jr. So I visited three more today. Unfortunately, the Caribbean Beach Resort no longer has a video arcade, but it did at one time. So by my count, I think there's still 8 more resorts to go. I hear the thunder in the background. So it's been a nice, enjoyable day over at the parks. Thanks again for joining me today. If you enjoyed watching this video, please hit that like button. Share with your family and friends as I smell the fish in the background here at the UK Pavilion. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. This is part 3 of the series looking for Fix-It Felix Jr. arcade game. So just because we haven't found it yet doesn't mean we're giving up. We're going to keep looking. And I'll do some more research online to see if we can get any more hints to if there's anywhere else that might actually have it, somewhere maybe outside of Walt Disney World parks. So until then, this is Marky Park, and we'll see you next time.